You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about MLOps, part one of three, managing your assets, managing your experiments, managing your models. It's all pretty cool. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to learn a little bit about MLOps. I have with me Shivani Patel. How are you doing, my friend?
Hi, how's it going?
Fantastic. Tell us who you are and what you do.
Hi, I'm Shivani. I am a program manager on the Azure Machine Learning Platform team. I specifically work on MLOps features.
Fantastic. So tell us what we're talking about today.
So today I'm going to talk a little bit about asset, artifact, and code management with MLOps on Azure Machine Learning. I'll show you some examples of how to do that end to end.
So let's start with, why is this something that's important and how can it be helpful?
For sure. So it's really, really important because being able to reproduce what you're doing on your local machine, you need to be able to track all the components that you're creating. So you can pass it on to your team, be able to, you know, reproduce that same model in the context of a different environment. So it gets really important when you're trying to scale out your ML workflows.
Fantastic. So how can you do this with our tools? Why don't you tell us?
For sure. So I'm going to go ahead and switch my screen here to show you. So here we have the Azure Machine Learning Studio. This is basically where you can see and visualize all your runs, your artifacts, and so on and so forth. So right here, we basically have these data sets, experiments, and models. And so what I've done is I've ran a training process here in my notebook, and these samples are available in our GitHub repo for Azure Machine Learning Notebooks. And so what I've basically done here is set up my development environment, connect to a workspace, and then as I'm, you know, creating my experiments, doing my training process, I'm registering everything. So right here, I'm creating an experiment to track everything that I'm creating, all the runs that I'm going to create. I'm attaching some compute here, as well as registering the data sets that I'm using. So this is really important so that you can track which data sets were used to produce a model. So you can go back and see if there's any bias in the data set. And then I'm going here and, you know, running through my classic training process. What's really great is that you can go back and visualize here in your data sets and see that, okay, here's the here's the data set that I registered, and see all the information about it and how to consume it if you want to use it in a different model. Additionally, I can see right here if I've created any models from this particular data set.
So let's talk a little bit about why it's important under MLOps to have these things versioned, registered, visualized. You talked about data sets, experiments, and what else did you talk about?
Models. About models, right. So
why is it important to do that?
So this is really important first, for a team of data sets to be able to share, you know, what models you've created, how you created them, what environment you use to build these models. So you can share that information across the team, saving time, saving effort in reproducing a similar model for a similar scenario. The other piece here is that teams are generally rotating across, you know, some large companies. We've talked to many customers where they have issues where one data scientist went ahead and created a really great model to solve a business problem just on their laptop. But being able to pass on that information to another team gets really difficult if you're not tracking each of these components. Additionally, on an end-to-end scale, if you're trying to understand and have visibility, auditability, and a view on what's actually happening in your pipelines, you need to be able to have the environment, the code that you're using, properly vetted. So if you don't have each of these components registered, there's no way you can have that lineage or that validation to show that, okay, this piece of the code was registered and validated, or this model was actually vetted using this data set.
So one of the things that's interesting when we talk about MLOps or DevOps in general is code. How do we keep track of code?
For sure. So I actually have a little example right here. So if you are using Git, you're running your notebooks, you're cloning them from a Git repository, what you can basically do here is we'll go ahead and automatically log that information for you. So right here, I finished my run, and I can scroll down here. And when you do a git.details, we're logging all the information. You know, it's a little difficult to see, but right here, we actually track which repository, which branch you're using to manage all of that code. So basically what you want to do is every time you're developing, you know, your training process and notebooks, you want to make sure that you're kind of pushing those into Git. It's not necessarily a tedious process, right? As long as you're pushing that into master, we're able to track which notebook the run or the training scripts are being used in.
That's awesome. So if someone already has a strategy for managing their own code, for example, let's say they use GitHub, that automatically will flow into what they're doing with Azure Machine Learning Service.
Exactly.
Okay. So we talked about managing data sets. We talked about managing experiments. We talked about managing models, which are like data science assets. We also talked about managing code. Well, we really didn't. We just said manage the code the way you manage your code. The interesting thing to me is if a developer is watching, why is it the interesting thing that I think we should talk about is managing data sets, because that's generally not something that's part of the regular development process. Why is managing data sets important, and what can you do in Azure Machine Learning Service to manage them properly?
Right. So reason managing data sets is so important is so that you have these validated data sets that have been gone through a cleansing process, that you know that, okay, these data sets have been vetted, they have no bias, and I can use them end-to-end for testing or testing when I'm pushing my model in a container into production. So, you know, these data sets are not only important in the model development process, they're also really important when you're going in and testing it in the context of the environment, right? And you want to be able to flow in these new data sets that are being created so you can go ahead and retrain the model. So when you have different versions of the data set, let's say you start with one set of data set, you ran the model, a new production came in, a new version of that same data set comes in, you want to be able to automatically pick up that information and track it right here. And so you can basically manage your file, all your file data sets in a centralized place.
And that's cool, because then when data scientists are working together, they're all working with the same code coming from the same Git repository, for example, the same data sets, and they can view each other's experiments and the outputs of those things, and then as well as work with the artifacts in Model Management Service.
Exactly. So one fun thing is you'll go into, you know, your experiments. Here's an experiment that I just ran. You're able to see, kind of the information not only about the run, but actually see, you know, which data set was used here. So you have the input data set right here that gives you that full lineage to look back and see what's being used. Believe it or not, I've talked to some customers who actually pass on their data sets through email. So this is a significantly better way to manage data sets.
I've heard of people passing them over zip files in a share somewhere, which is equally frightening. Well, this has been amazing. We've learned about how to do MLOps by managing your code, wherever you're managing it. We talked about managing experiments. We also talked about managing models as well as data sets. Anything I'm missing?
Nope, that's pretty much it.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us. Thank you so much for watching. We've been learning all about MLOps, the very first part. This is the first part in a series of 3 videos. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.